today. In the last class, we have seen about the frame set concept. In frame set, we have discussed how we insert horizontal frame set as well as vertical frame set. These two frame set we have covered in the previous class. In this class, first we understand about the concept of nested frame set. Look this. To insert one frame within the other frame, this called nested means if you have already one frame and you want to insert one more frame inside that, then this concept is known as nested frame. This can be done by the nested frame set within the same window. Let's see how it is possible. Look this here. First tag name is HTML tag. You have to write HTML because this is the root tag or main tag. Without this tag, you cannot start your HTML coding. So this is compulsory. You have to write HTML and at the last you have to close HTML tag. Then frame set is used to say about how many rows or how many columns you want to create. So in this we are saying that rows means we want to create two rows, first frame of 50% and similarly another frame is of 50%. Then now look this frame set rows equals to 50% frame src equals to a.html. So this will come in first row. This will come in the first row because first row width we have given 50%. That means look this, frame one will come in a row manner. Now look this, a.html page will come in the row manner, row wise. Now what about second row? What about this second row? Look this, frame set calls equals to 20, 75%. That means here in the second row, this means this 50% will again divide into 25% and 75% in a column manner. That's why here calls is written. Means in the first row, only first page will display, first frame will display like a.html. But in the second row, that is the 50% part. Look this, this one is a 50% remaining of the main page, remaining of the main document. Okay. This one is again divided into two sub parts that is called 25% and 75%. So 25% is the first column in second row and 75% is the third frame in the second row. Same second row is divided into two parts. Two parts means in two columns, into vertical column, vertical lines like this. Okay, so this is the concept of nested frame set. Here we used both vertical as well as horizontal frame set. Now here this frame set is closed. So this frame set is for inner one. This frame set is for inner one, or this frame set is for outer one, this one. Because which one you open last, it will close first. Now let's see, if you open brick bracket first and then curly braces, after that small bracket like this. So first of all, you have to close a small bracket, then curly braces. And at the last, you have to close big bracket. Similarly here, first one, this inner frame set will close, and at the last one means outer frame set will close. It is same as which you used in the maths. Clear? Let's see the example. Look, in the previous class we already created three pages. Its name is a.html, b.html and c.html. Now use these three pages here in this. First of all, write HTML. HTML is a root tag. Your code will begin from here. After that, if you want to use head tag, it is optional. You can use, otherwise don't worry about this. No title, then what we are doing here? Creating nested frames. Now close this title. After that, close this head tag. After that, start body tag. Then, okay, here in case of frame set, body tag is not used. Don't write body tag in case of nested or in case of frame set. FRAME, frame, SET, frame set. Then what you want to do, if you want to create two rows, to write rows equals to similar example, 50% comma 50%, like this. Now close this. After that, inside this I want to insert first frame. Frame SRC equals to a.html. Then inside this same, in second row, I want to divide the second row into two columns. For this, again, we have to use calls. Frame set tag calls equals to 25%. This example is written in your book. 25%, and then remaining one is 75%. So here you have to write 75%. Like this. Then frame SRC equals to b.html. Similarly, frame SRC equals to c.html. Now close this frame set. This means we have closed inner frame set and then close this outer frame set. Outer means this one. This is the outer frame set. Here we closed at the last, or this inner frame set we closed first. Look, this is closed. At the last, you have to close your HTML tag, HTML, and then you save your file. Its name is nested frame set. Nested frame set dot HTML, and then save this page. Let's see the output. Nested frame set. This is created. Double click on this. Now see, first row and second row. In this page, we are having two rows. First row having red color, and second row is divided into two columns by using this line. Because in second row, we want to write two page. Two pages means two frames. First frame of 25% and second frame is of 75%. That's why we have written like this. Clear? So output of this page is similar. For in first row red page, because a.html having background color red, b.html having background color blue, and c.html having background color yellow. Is it clear? Show me your response. Is it clear? If any doubt, please ask. Show me your responses. Very good. Show me your responses. Either you have to write your message in chat box or show me your thumb impression, whatever you have method, please do it. Very good. Means most of the students understand this. Very good. Okay, very good. Now, next topic. Next topic is no frame. No frame. This element is used when the frames are not supported by the browser. Means if your browser is not support the concept of frame, then you can display message with the help of no frame tag. See the definition. This element is used when the frames are not supported by the browser. If frame concept, this frame concept is not supported, this time in our computer, in my computer, this concept is supported by the browser. That's why I am explaining this. But if your browser is not supported, so what you have to use? You have to use here no frame tag. Look this, no frame tag. Look this. This element is used when frames are not supported by the browser or it is to disabled by the browser. So it is used to display contents when frames are not supported. It is possible only when your browser not support the concept of frame. जब आपका ब्राउजर फ्रेम का कॉन्सेप्ट सपोर्ट नहीं करेगा तभी आपका ये टैग काम करेगा, लेकिन इस टाइम पर मेरे लैपटॉप में ये काम नहीं करेगा because of my browser supports the concept of frame. That's why. Look this example. I have prepared one example for you already. Look this. Your page start from HTML tag. This is the root tag. After that, frame set. I want to divide my main page, main document into two parts in a column manner, like 50%, 50%. If my browser not support the concept of frame, then it will display this one line. If my browser not support, जब नहीं करेगा तो ये line लिख के आ जाएगी. क्या आएगी? Your browser doesn't support frames. ये line लिख के आएगी. Otherwise means if it is supported, then it will display these two pages in a main document. Just execute this page, run this page. Now see, we got two output, page a.html and b.html in a main document. This time it not displayed this message. Ye message nahi aaya hamare samne. Your browser does not support frames. Ye nahi aaya because my browser supports the concept of frame. That's why this message is not displayed on the screen. Is it clear? Show me your responses. Is it clear? Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Okay. Mansi Makhija, is it clear or not? Mansi Makhija of class 7th. Very good. Tanya Adhikari, is it clear? Tanya Adhikari, is it clear? Okay. Next topic is floating frames. Next is Harshdeep Kaur is saying that please re-explain this no frame. Look this, no frame means this is support only those browsers, this concept is support by only those browser who does not support the concept of frame. जो ब्राउजर फ्रेम का कॉन्सेप्ट सपोर्ट नहीं करते हैं उनके लिए वी हैव टू यूज नो फ्रेम कॉन्सेप्ट. जिसमें फ्रेम कॉन्सेप्ट नहीं चलता, जिन ब्राउजर में नहीं चलेगा उसमें हम नो फ्रेम लगाएंगे. बट दिस टाइम इन माय कंप्यूटर इट इज सपोर्टेड, इस टाइम पर ये सपोर्ट कर रहा है फ्रेम का कॉन्सेप्ट, सो दिस लाइन विल नॉट डिस्प्लेड ऑन द स्क्रीन. ये जो लाइन लिखी थी, योर ब्राउजर डज नॉट सपोर्ट फ्रेम्स, ठीक है. जस्ट लाइक आप एटीएम मशीन में जाते हो और एटीएम में एटीएम कार्ड इंसर्ट करते हो तो क्या होता है, पासवर्ड करेक्ट होता है तो मनी विड्रॉल होती है, मनी विड्रॉ हो जाती है. और सपोज पासवर्ड इनकरेक्ट होता है तो आपके सामने एक मैसेज आता है, इनकरेक्ट पिन, इनकरेक्ट पासवर्ड, प्लीज टाइप करेक्ट पासवर्ड, इस टाइप से मैसेज आपके सामने डिस्प्ले हो जाता है, ठीक है. सिमिलरली ये हमने एक मैसेज दे दिया है, यदि आप में आपके ब्राउजर में फ्रेम कॉन्सेप्ट सपोर्ट नहीं करेगा तो ये मैसेज डिस्प्ले होगा, और कर जाता है तो ये दो पेज आ जाएंगे. इज इट क्लियर हर्षदीप? हर्षदीप इट इज क्लियर? ओके नाउ फ्लोटिंग फ्रेम. फ्लोटिंग फ्रेम मींस आई फ्रेम. Before going to start this topic, first we will understand how we will insert image in the web page. This topic is left in the chapter number, I think, 7. Chapter number 7, that is the last chapter of your, last topic of your chapter, means inserting images. So, how we will insert image in HTML, look this. For inserting an image, we will use img tag. Img tag is called image tag. Img src. Src is called source of the page. Source of the page, yeah, source of the image. IMG stand for image, SRC stand for source. Source of the image means from where we have to take picture, we have to take image. This time I have taken one image which is located at C drive inside this users folder. Inside this, this is another folder, then one more folder, and these are the folder separate by this backslash sign. All the folders are separated by this backslash sign. At the end, we have to write name of the picture. See this, name of the picture is session 1 self-management skills .jpg. So .jpg is the extension of the picture. Look this, where it is kept. Now, I'm opening this. Folder name is pictures. Double click on this. See this. This is an image. This is an image. I want to insert this image on the web page. Right click on this and go to the properties. See the here location. Location is where this picture is kept. C drive. Users is a folder, then again this is a folder, again this one is a folder. So this is the complete path of the picture. After that you have to write name of the picture at the end. So see this here, I have written this complete path, I have taken this complete path from there, and at the end I have written this name of the picture with its extension. How would I know the extension of this picture is this? Look this. Here, .jpg is written. .jpg is written. That means the extension of this picture is .jpg. Means this is a JPG file. This is a JPG file. That's why I have written this. And then width of the picture is 500. Height of the picture is 500. Align equals to left. See this output. Output of this page. Image. Now see the output. Image is appeared in the left hand side or in a square manner. Why? Because the height and width of this image is same. Height and image both are, width both are same. Second method, if your picture is placed in the same location, if your picture is placed in the same location where this file is placed, so no need to write this whole thing. ये जो complete path लिखा है मैंने, no need to write this whole thing. You have to write your picture name only with the extension .jpg. Simply you have to write session 1 self management skills .jpg. This much you have to write and save your file. Save your file and then again execute. See this. Again, same picture will appear in my screen. Why? Because this picture is also kept on the desktop. Look this. This picture is also kept on the desktop. If the location of the picture and location of your file both in the same place, then there is no need to write complete path, complete address. If your picture is not here, if your picture is not here and you want to write like this simply, then you can get this type of image. Means ek sign banke aa jayega ye aur baki picture banke nahi aayegi. Why? Because picture is not placed here in the same location. So for this, what we have to do, go to the pictures folder and then right click, copy this picture and then paste it here. Now picture location and the file location, the file name is image. This file location and picture location both are same, means both are placed on the desktop. Now see, our picture is appeared. If the location of picture and location of your file both are same, then no need to write complete path. Us time pe aapko complete path dene ki zarurat nahi hai. Otherwise you have to write path of the picture. Is it clear? Yes or no? Very good. Ishita, is it clear? Okay. Kajal Saxena, is it clear? That's great. Now next topic. Next topic is iframe. Iframe, this is a tag name. This tag is for floating frames. Look this. These floating frames are like images that exist on web pages. The iframe tag is used to place the floating frame on the web page. This iframe has attributes such as name, SRC, margin width, margin height, scrolling, align. You can understand more when you see its output. This is the file I have prepared for you. Same code I have written for you already. Look this, which is written in your book. I have written like this. Only I have changed name of the picture, because that name, that picture name I don't have. Jo picture book ke paas hai, book ke paas kaun si picture hai? Prachi logo. This is the picture name in a GIF format. But this picture I don't have. Mere paas nahi hai ye picture. So that's why I have taken picture session 1 self management skills .jpg. I have taken this picture. Clear? Now see this iframe, SRC. SRC means source. It is same as image tag. Only Here I made change. क्या आई फ्रेम लिखा है इंस्टीड ऑफ आई एम जी. ओनली दिस मच आई हैव डन. रिमेनिंग ऑल थिंग्स आर सेम. नाउ रन दिस पेज. नाउ रन दिस पेज. लुक दिस. हियर दिस पिक्चर कैन फ्लोट. देखो इस पिक्चर को मैं मूव करा सकता हूं लाइक दिस. दिस इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ फ्लोटिंग. फ्लोटिंग मीन्स गोइंग फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर. देखो टॉप टू डाउन बॉटम टू टॉप हम इसे मूव करा सकते हैं. बट सिंपली बाई यूजिंग इमेज टैग वी कैन नॉट मूव पिक्चर. पिक्चर को हम मूव नहीं करा सकते हैं इन केस ऑफ आई एम जी. बट इन केस ऑफ आई फ्रेम वी कैन मूव अवर पिक्चर. ये देखो मूव हो रही है पिक्चर. ठीक है फ्लोट कर रही है ना. ठीक है इज इट क्लियर.